Hey guys, what is up? I am DevilDriven. Lots of fun yesterday with the patch, the expansion, seeing the full scope of the expansion since all the cards have been released. Lots of fun. Loving Nilfgaard. I actually really like Invigorate. I'm gonna jam this list a lot. I'm having a lot of fun with it. It is Devotion. I had another version that I put in the thing, but I believe I got it a little bit more optimized, I think. Going through the cards, it is a Feign Death. Every list I built, I put a scenario in it. The Northern Realms list I got that I'm going to try to put up for either tomorrow or Friday, it has the scenario for Rafard's Revenge. But the idea is to get last say with either Skaggs or the 1-2 punch with the Valley and the Watchers, or as I like to call him, Jose Canseco. He's got his bat ready. I love this art, man. I don't know. Some people were shitting on this art. I think this dude's badass. He looks like he's ready to smack some fools. So Isengrim Council works out pretty well. It's kind of underwhelming when you have Skaggs and you have to pull it with it, but it's something. It plays for the 8 provisions that it's got. You really want it in hand, preferably. But also, too, it can pull for sure Dunka, putting her at a 6 with 1 armor, which is kind of hard to remove. I do have the enchanted armor. You buff Torque, and then you get a rando buff there. Simless is preferably pulled for Bountiful Harvest. This combo is so good. You'll see in the video here. Spoilers, it's not a short game, but it's only one game today, I apologize. We got 1 smuggler, proactivity. The Blathanas are really nice, especially when you get the Simless. Even if they do knock them down a little bit, you can bump them back up off of each other and get value, which is huge, huge. I did run into a scenario with monsters where if they respawn these with that Witch's Sabbath, you're probably going to overswarm and lose. Just spoilers on that one. I like the defenders. They're not procs for the Feign Death, but just having something proactive that might get buffed is huge. And then I got a Vryhead Saboteur, possible dry pass play, I guess. If you feel like you got enough boosts, I try to go heavy round 1, try to win the round, bleed with Feign Death, and try to get last say with either a Skaggs or a Watcher, and it usually turns out pretty well. I go up against a Melusine Geti Turtle with the new great swords and everything. So I think this is a really fun game. I think it showcases the power of the deck. I think it's really good, and I hope you guys enjoy it. I'll see you guys at the end. Oh, and upvote the list. Thank you again for getting me on the front page again. It helps me out. You have no idea so much. So if you like the list, upvote the list, please. I'll see you at the end. Druids. Just when you thought things were about, we gotta bleed this deck. Long round, we can't hang. It's still got the mermaids. I can hand buff this, but is that too slow? I keep my boys in hand. I think we drop this, try to get some golds. Okay. We have to keep these two. Let's just drop this. Okay, good. Alright. So first we grab up this. Boost up our Torque. What's it get? On one of our thick boys. So now we pull Dunka. Try and get some more. The only good human is a dead human. She's up to a 6. Melusine. We could just kill that. And to be honest, he needs the rain to function. Okay, this is good. Another engine. Melusine. So now we drop this. We might have to play these. He wants a longer round, though. Should have played it on the other side. That's so bad. We might have to play these this round.
The sea demands a price, and you shall pay it.
All right, so we go here. Bleed this. And then hopefully this can, he passes. Okay, that's good. I guess we lose out on this, but whatever. We can't go into a long round versus that. It just nukes us. We need some more golds. Shoot. I guess this is a nice opener. We drop this. No simless, no call. Ouch. So simless is going to be circle. We still have forest protector. But we got to... We need five here, so we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Alright. So we go here first. I guess we get this down. Oh, that's a messenger. That's fine. We get this down. Oh, wait. We could do it that way. We go here, here, and then here. Nah, we just get the feign death down. Yeah, next we get the bleed down. So he's drawing his scenario, so we just put the bleed on that.
With me, you'll forget your sorrows.
That's fine. Actually no, we go here. Because then we could drop, we could play this, possibly smack that for three, get this, get the proc. Plays it now. So he's got, he's a, oh, okay. That's fine. So let's see what we get. We take the circle. I guess here, right? We buff Sheldon. We lost a point, but... Well, we lost 3 points, but we got rid of his synergy there. I guess next we go here. Well, we could get the bleed down.
In the end,
so he gets two, but he only loses. We just bleed this. Seven. I guess we could play this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Four more, now we get out.
We'll run upon the crest of the waves.
Because he's just going to play the home run. It was a good pass. We should have a good last say on Fulmar, or on Melusine. We got carry over. He got carry over though. Melusine's up to 20, but we just smacked that with Sheldon. Using this was kind of bad last round, but he knew that he would get smacked with it. So we have circle for Simless. Oh wait, we have both of these. Beautiful. I thought we had one in hand. So we can get three of them. Oh, we kept Genneth, really? So we go melee.
Above sabotage,
guess we bump up this to try to get it to live. So does he bring back?
Man is an arrogant creature.
I guess we get this up as big as we can. We take the for sure. To try and kill it. Next we go Dolblethana. Draco Turtle. So now he reses a... He didn't play a priest, did he? No. Okay. So we go here.
There is no place more beautiful.
Next we go Simless for double harvest. Ah, the Melusine. But we get to smack it, which is nice. Alright. So we go here. This one goes melee. Harvest. Get another one. Get another one.
There is no place more beautiful.
Hopefully we can get some hand buffs. We get another one here, then we play Torque. I guess we could play this first. And then we for sure get the buff on Torque. And Sheldon. Why offering in the scene now? Ah, oh, that's super sad. We go here, 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 here. That really ruined us. Because we don't get anything off of these. I mean, we get something, but if it hits it again. Well, at least it didn't hit there. So we go here, here,
reach high into the sky.
Here, here, here.
Splendid crops this year, and ever they shall be. Leave it to
me. We gotta go back row. No, do we? Yeah, we have to go back row. And go here. Okay. So his last cards. How does he res this? He's used. Oh, we missed. What was his last card? Another Mardrum? Can't use that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh, we can. I guess it doesn't proc anyways, though. Sheldon, I think we're short. We were able to save him, and we got through Gedneath, Melusine, and the turtle. Okay, okay. Hey, that's the video for today, guys. Sorry, short one. I like the boosty boys. I really think it works out well if you get value of the Watcher in a 1-2 punch. The Watcher is sometimes better than the Skags, but getting last say is huge with this deck once again. Thank you so much for everything. Thank you for everybody that upvoted the list. There'll be a deck guide for this one as well. Thank you for everything. I'll see you guys next time.